Hello and welcome to this brief tutorial on installing your own R packages on CHPC resources. I'd first like to mention the web documentation on chpc.utah.edu. So if you go to chpc.utah.edu and click on documentation, software, and then on the left column there is R. And then if you click on this link in the index here, installing additional R packages, it will cover the instructions I'm going over today in much more detail. So if you ever run into any trouble with this video, or if you have any further questions, please look here first. And this is the main source of information about installing your own R packages on CHPC resources, and it's definitely updated the most frequently. In order to install your own R packages or libraries, you'll need to have your own version of the module. The module that is installed by the user services team has its packages and libraries installed by the user services team simply because of the permissions on the directories for the libraries and packages. Any user can't write to them. So in order to have your own libraries and packages that you've installed yourself, you will need to have your own version of the module. So the module can be loaded with module load R, and this will load the system version. And if I run R, you'll see that I'm currently using R version 3.4.4. However, your version number might be different, though the instructions for this video should be much the same for more recent versions of R. You can also see that I have loaded 3.4.4 with ML, and it will tell you I am currently using R 3.4.4. So again, we want to create our own version of this R module. We want to have a user version and not just the system version. In order to do that, we need a directory for it. So I'm going to create a directory called personal modules. I'm in my home directory here, but you can put it basically anywhere that you have read, write access to. And let me actually create a subdirectory here as well. So use -p to make all of these. And I'll make /r. So now I have a new directory called personal modules, and in that directory I have a subdirectory called r, and that's where I want to put my new Lua script that defines my personal version of this module. So I'm going to need to copy it from the system branch, the Lua script for the r module that I'm currently using, and this is at a pretty long path. It's at uufs.chpc.utah.edu sys module files chpc-18 in all caps core with the capital C R and then $r_version to evaluate to the version of R that I'm currently using, which again is 3.4.4, but it may be different for you, though this command should stay the same, because any updated versions of the module should also have an updated variable associated with them. So I'll copy that .lua file, this Lua script, to personal modules /r. And so when I look in personal modules /r, I now have my own copy of this script. So this is where we will keep the module in this personal modules /r, in my case, directory here. But we don't have any place to install packages and libraries to. So I'm also going to create a directory called rlibs in my home directory. And I will create a subdirectory for the version of R that I'm using so I can associate all of the packages and libraries with one version with the module of the same version. So there's no errors with version numbers here. So now I have a directory for my libraries and packages, and I have a directory for my modules. And they're not linked. I need to point this new R module file that I have here, this Lua script, to this new directory that I've created to store my modules, or my packages, excuse me, for that version of R. So in order to do that, I actually need to go in and edit this script here, this 3.4.4.lua file. So I'll go ahead and open this in Vim. You can open it in any text editor. But I'll modify personal modules /r/3.4.4.lua. and I need to set the path for this package directory. And you do this with the setenv command. It's actually very similar to this prepend path command, so I'm going to go ahead and copy this, and then I will paste it, and we'll call this the path to user libraries. Okay, so the command, we don't actually want to set the path here, and we actually need to change this to setenv. Excuse me. And we don't want to change path, we want to change r_libs_user. And the value we want to change it to is, we're going to keep this path join, but we're going to have it be uufschpc.utah.edu. And then instead of this sys branch, we're going to change it to let's actually have a value for the user's ID. So it will just evaluate to the user ID, so it would become my unit for my home directory. So I'll add in os.getenv user to get the user environment variable. And then we'll also throw in rlibs to get to the rlibs directory. And then the version of the R module that we're going to use, which you can access with the my module version function thing here. So this path will become uufschpc.utah.edu/common/home/myunid/rlibs/the version of the module, which will evaluate to the version that I am currently using. So once I have that, I'll go ahead and save this file. And now I want to actually load that version of the module, my own version of this module. So in order to do that, I'll actually have to first unload the system version with module unload R. And if I list modules again, I no longer have a version of R here. And then I need to module use personal modules, or whatever you named your directory for your own modules, the top level directory for your modules. And now when I run module load R, it will again load R3.4.4, but if I do module show R, it will include the new path that I've specified. It will include rlibs user, the environment variable, as this path in my home directory that I've just specified. If you want to make this a little bit more permanent, you can put module use and then the directory for your personal modules in your .custom.sh or .custom.csh files in your home directory. And those are loaded by bashrc and tcshrc, depending on whether you're using bash or tcsh respectively. And they will run this command every time you log in, so you no longer have to run that module use command that I ran a bit ago every time you log in. So if I look at cat and then .custom.sh, here's an example of how you would do that. Just take it out of this if statement and just put it at the bottom of the file or something and say module use and then in my case /personal modules, and that would load that directory into the module path every time I log in. So now we have a custom version of the module, and we also have a directory for storing our libraries and packages. So the next step is to actually install something. So we can start up R just by running R at the command line. And this is the interface we'll be using to install it. I'm going to do the high level installation, which you only really want to use if you don't have any C, C++, or Fortran libraries or any special paths that the installation requires. So basically, if it's just a nice directory structure that just has basic R scripts in it, you can use the high level installation process. Otherwise, if you have to set some flags or some paths at the installation time, you'll need to use low-level installation, which I won't cover in this video because it changes drastically for different packages. So there's an example on the CHPC documentation. If I scroll down here to the bottom, there's high-level installation, which I'll be doing. I'll be doing this example here. And then there's also low-level installation where you need to specify flags like library, configure, all these sort of lower-level tasks that in most cases, most package developers try to avoid. So I'm going to try and load the market sim package by running library and then market sim. And it will tell me that it resulted in an error because I don't have that package. So I can now install it though with this command here that I'm going to just copy for the sake of brevity. And in most cases, you can actually copy the format of this command because many of the packages are on the R project website. So if you're using this as the repository and you set up your directories the same way I did with the rlibs in your home directory, this command should work just fine for any package on CRAN. And you can just change the name here. So let's run this command and it will run through the installation process. And now if I try to do library market sim again, it loads and I can now use whatever software this contains. So if I look in rlibs now in my home directory and the version number that I'm using, there's now a directory for market sim, and that's where the files for that package live, for that library. Again, if you have to do a low-level installation, I'd recommend just following some of the instructions on the CHPC website. And please don't hesitate to reach out if you have any questions about that, or if you run into any trouble installing any lower-level package. I hope this video was helpful. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to email us at helpdesk@chpc.utah.edu. Or you can stop by our offices in INSEC 405. Thanks for watching.